Are those your babies? And you love them?
Oh, that's pretty cute.
Hi everyone, and if you're watching this as it comes out, Happy New Year. I am currently fostering this beautiful, friendly mama cat and her four babies. So I have Mama Firework, Sparkler, Party Hat, Smooch, and Bubbly. Caring for a feline family is so rewarding. So today I am going to be sharing with you my top three tips for caring for a mama cat and her babies. First things first, make sure you have a proper setup. When you're caring for a mom and babies, you don't want them to have free access to your house. You don't want mama to be able to move from room to room where she might be tempted to hide her babies in your closet or in your pantry. You want her to be in one confined space. Think something like a guest room or a laundry room or even a bathroom. You should create a safe and inviting nesting box for mama in the corner of the room. Cats tend to feel safest in a corner, and mom cats in particular love being covered. So I like having something like this that is a nesting box that's covered that can fit into the corner of the room. Mama cats tend to be pretty happy with a setup like this, so they're not going to be searching for somewhere else to bring their babies. In the bottom of the kennel, I'll just put a light layer of blankets, and then on top, I'll put a large blanket. And if the mama is feeling stressed out, you can just partially or fully cover her with the blanket. In whatever space you choose, you want to make sure that they have minimal access to items that can be harmful to them. Mama cats are looking for somewhere safe to hide away with their babies. So sometimes that's going to take the form of mom trying to climb a 10-foot bookshelf with a baby in her mouth. Sometimes they might try to burrow into a pull-out couch and hide their babies underneath it, but that could be dangerous for them too. So just be mindful of furniture items that are in the room and reducing access to them. You also want to think about the kinds of cat bedding that you're giving them. There are some wonderfully fluffy beds that you can get, but you don't want to get anything with deep crevices where a baby can get stuck and suffocate. You want everything to be pretty flat and smooth. I also don't recommend using small hideaway beds with mama. You want her to have enough space to really stretch out, be able to nurse her babies, and be able to have everybody in there comfortably. It's important too that you keep the mom and babies away from other animals. So even if you have a very friendly dog or cat in your house, please do not have them in the same space as the mama and her babies. It'll keep the babies physically safer. It will keep the mama less stressed so she can focus on caring for them. And it will reduce the risk of disease spread. Obviously, mama is gonna need some other things too. So in an adjacent corner, you can go ahead and put her litter box. I recommend using a nice large litter box that's a little bit shallow so that once the babies are ready to start going to the bathroom on their own, they can actually get into it. And then of course, she's going to need an area for her food and water. Please make sure that when you have tiny babies, you are not putting a deep dish of water in the room. You just wanna give mama a nice shallow dish of fresh water. Something I really like about this setup is that mama will spend most of her time with her babies, but then she can also come out and walk around, stretch her legs, use the litter box, get some snacks, and get some lovin'. Oh, and this one loves lovin'. You are the sweetest mama cat in history. One last thing to consider is the temperature in the room. Neonatal kittens cannot thermoregulate, so they rely on heat from their mama's body and from the environmental temperature. So unless the room is quite warm, you want to make sure they have access to an external heat source, something like a heat pad. My second tip is to make sure that you know how to monitor the kitten's health. A lot of people assume that mama cat can do everything for her babies and that you don't really need to intervene. And while that's often true, that mama can feed her babies and help them grow into strong, robust kittens, sometimes that's not the case. You won't really know how your kittens are doing unless you are monitoring them every single day. So one thing you need to do is make sure that you are weighing your kittens at least twice a day using a gram scale. Make sure that you write down the weight so that you can monitor if their weight is going up or if it's going down. If their weight is going down, you need to be prepared to intervene with supplemental feeding. Of course, as long as their weight is going up throughout the day, that's not going to be necessary. But if their weight is going down for more than 2 or 3 feedings, you will need to intervene. While you're weighing the kittens, you want to visually inspect them. You want to see, do they have any kinds of wounds? Do they have any fleas or visible parasites? Do they have any discharge? How do they look? It's important to know that these babies can and should receive medical care if something is going on. For instance, these kittens had horrible fleas when they came, so we had to treat both the babies and the mama. So at least twice a day, I recommend that you are weighing your kittens and checking on them physically. This is also a good opportunity for the kittens to get some hands-on time with humans so that they will be nice and sweet and social when they get older. Make sure that you talk with your vet if you're concerned about their health, and please talk to your vet before giving any kind of over-the-counter medication to the babies or to mom. And finally, I do recommend, if you're able, to have some kind of baby monitor or a security camera so that you can monitor what's going on. This gives me a lot of peace of mind so I can check in even if I'm not right there with them. And it's nice to be able to monitor what she's doing throughout the day. Fortunately, this mama has been an absolute angel so far, and she loves it in her nesting box. My third tip is to make sure that you are taking great care of mama. Mom cats do a ton of work, and they need a lot of calories to get them through the day. Make sure that the mom cat has ample amounts of food and that she is eating a kitten food. I like to give access to both wet and dry and make sure it's a high quality kitten food because that is more rich in protein and fat, which she's gonna need for keeping 4 babies fed. Make sure that you are giving her a nice large meal at least 3 times a day for the duration of her time nursing. You also want to monitor and nurture mom's health. Once a day, I recommend just taking a look at her belly and making sure that everything looks nice and healthy. Sometimes mama cats can have a bacterial infection of the milk ducts called mastitis. Mastitis happens when their mammary glands are inflamed and it blocks milk production. You might notice that their teats feel hot to the touch. They might be swollen or firm or even look like there's some bruising. If you think that the mama cat might have mastitis, please treat it like an emergency. Make sure that you are providing supplemental feeding to the babies while they're not able to nurse, and make sure you're taking her into the veterinarian to see if she needs an antibiotic. Of course, there are any number of other veterinary issues that can come up for mama cats, so make sure that you are addressing those promptly with a vet. And finally, just like you're going to be spaying and neutering the babies, make sure you have an appointment to spay the mom too. Motherhood might be sweet to observe, but we do not need these mama cats having litter after litter after litter. While we're still living in a world where there are so many kittens being born year after year after year and not enough resources to save them, there's really no excuse for allowing a cat to keep having kittens. Spaying the mother cat is going to be better for her health, for her happiness, and for the betterment of all kitten kind. I hope that this video was helpful to you, and I wish you the best of luck on your fostering journey. Remember, if you are fostering a feral mom and babies, I do have a video on that subject, and you can watch that for more tips on fostering moms who are a little bit less social than firework. Good luck and happy fostering!